Hello, Gravity Falls fans. So, I'm sure we are still all reeling a bit from our last cliffhanging episode. And with what people are assuming is the final episode of Season 2 coming out in July, I thought it might be fun to do some speculation on what's to come. Now, there's been rumblings about this final episode being solely about Grunkle Stan and his twin brother. And of course, we all want to see more about that. But if this actually is the closing of Season 2, there's lots of characters still left with somewhat open origins. I'm calling them loose end characters, any of whom could be pivotal to the plot at later points. Let's start with the most obvious loose end character, Seuss. We all remember the earlier code saying, "The handyman knows more than you think," as well as his computer password seeming to fit into the password slot for McGucket's strange computer. So this seems to hint that he's in on the whole thing. And aside from his grandma's hilarious comment about his grandfather being in hell,
"Before I ascend to heaven and live with the angels."
"And with grandpa."
"No, he is not there."
We know that Seuss's father has largely been MIA. His age should coincide with that of the elder mystery twins. So could he be involved as well? Perhaps he's living in the same dimension where Stan's brother came from, thus explaining his absence. There's plenty of questions to ask, and I would expect to discover quite a bit about Seuss on the front end of the third season. Let's move on to Pacifica. A somewhat recent development from the Northwest Mansion episode reveals the Northwest family to be collectors of llama paintings, and this would seem to indicate that Pacifica fills the llama role in the symbol circle. Ah, yes, the old symbol circle. Been a while since we've seen it. Now, in my very original Gravity Falls video, some people got mad because I left the llama spot blank, saying Mabel is both the star and the llama. But I think this one makes more sense, especially given how much development Pacifica's had recently, which I'm pretty okay with. But where are we left with the other slots? Well, everyone's got their own opinions on some of the symbols, and here are mine moving forward. Now, one common thought is that these glasses are Stan's twins, but holding on to my opinion that each symbol belongs only to one character, I think the six-fingered hand now officially belongs to Stan's twin. For one, it's representative of the author, and, well, also the six fingers are kind of a dead giveaway. So how about the ice? Well, there's signs that it's Wendy, but I'm still not 100% sold on this one just yet, personally. And these glasses, well, they could belong to a character we haven't met yet, which is what I favor. Or some say they could belong to Sheriff Blubbs, but it seems like a bit of a stretch. But that brings me to our next set of loose end characters, Candy and Grenda. While Candy has glasses too, they don't seem quite to match, but that doesn't mean she isn't suspiciously involved. A page once flipped through the journal revealed this Freddy Krueger-like character, reminding us of this pose that Candy once struck. Could these be related in some way? I mean, Candy certainly doesn't seem very evil or Freddy Krueger-like, but it's hard to deny the similarities. Maybe it's just a bit of a callback? Who knows? But I would say that both of these two are prime candidates for some large developments in the future. Penultimately, I'd like to bring up Old Man McGucket, because while he still has some mystery to shroud his background, we will likely get lots about him in the flashbacks of Stan and his brother. However, there is something jarring or strange to me about the fact that he seemingly isn't represented in the symbol circle. For such an important character, you'd think he'd be tied in. Not to say he couldn't be in the future, but given his significance, there's something peculiar about it. He hasn't got the proper glasses or the six fingers, so maybe he was just a pure red herring. And yes, of course, some really good comedic gold.
"Are you okay?" "Okay as I'll ever
Barbie!
What?
But last I'll talk about Robbie, who I've already speculated will have some large developments to come. With his clear knowledge of dark magic and striking similarities from the zombie characters from Season 1, I'm hoping we'll see him developed further and hopefully somewhat involved in the core plot. Much like other members of the town who were involved in the secret society, he easily could be a part of something entirely different. As I mentioned about McGucket's absence from the Circle, Robbie's presence in the Circle hints that he will have some serious involvement, and possibly soon. Now, there are plenty of characters, from Wendy to Gideon to many of the colorful characters of the town, all of whom could be talked about and speculated upon, and especially Bill Cipher, who you can dig plenty up on the web, but by and large, he's kind of still a giant mystery. But for now, I want to ask you guys, which characters do you think will become more involved in the story? Which are red herrings, and what other speculations might you make about the story or characters moving forward? I can't wait to hear what you guys think and where you think things will go from here. The sky is kind of the limit, and then it kind of isn't because we're going between dimensions, so it kind of transcends the sky. Well, you know what I'm saying. With all of this weirdness, portals, and especially time travel thrown into the mix, who knows what kind of weirdness we're in for. So look forward to lots more Gravity Falls content from me as new episodes continue to air. For now, thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon, Gravity Falls fans.